3.
Whether you're measuring chocolate or the amount of hydrochloric acid to add to your solution, there will always be a difference between the measured value and the actual value. This difference is known as the error. Generally, in science, we assume that the error is plus or minus 1 of the first uncertain digit. But what is an uncertain digit? The first uncertain digit is the one that we are uncertain about because we cannot read it directly off the measuring device and are forced to estimate it. For example, if you're measuring the height of a dog with a meter stick that only has tick marks for each inch, and your little dog is just a little taller than 8 inches, then you're certain that the dog's height is more than 8 inches. But you're uncertain about how much more than 8 inches your dog's height is. So you estimate that your dog is 8.5 inches tall. The 0.5 in 8.5 is the first uncertain digit. So we assume that the dog's real height is 8.5 inches plus or minus 0.1. When we're making measurements, we include all significant figures. Significant figures are the digits that we are completely confident about plus the first uncertain digit. So for the 8.5 inches that you measured your dog's height as, there are two significant figures, since we are certain about the 8 and the 0.5 is our first uncertain digit. So, let's talk about which figures are significant and which are not. First, non-zero integers are always significant figures. So if I have 52, I have two significant figures. If I have 52.2, I have three significant figures. And if I have 52.222, I have five significant figures. Second, zeros are only significant figures when they are captive zeros or trailing zeros in numbers with decimals. Leading zeros are never significant figures. Let's unpack what those three types of zeros are. Captive zeros, which are zeros between two non-zero numbers, are always significant figures. So, 1.008 has four significant figures. Captive zeros are held captive by the other significant figures and are significant figures themselves. For instance, imagine that you have a ruler that has tick marks for every millimeter. You measure that your eraser is 2.05 centimeters tall. 2.05 then has three significant figures because you're certain that the eraser is more than 2 centimeters tall. You're certain that the eraser is not 2.1 centimeters tall, meaning that you are certain about the 0, and then you estimate the 5, which is your first uncertain digit. Leading zeros are zeros that come at the beginning of a number, and they are never significant figures. So 0.0025 only has two significant figures. Don't let leading zeros lead you on. They are not significant figures. That's because when you measure that something is 2.5 centimeters, you are certain about the 2 and the 5. But if I instead wrote it as 0.025 meters, those zeros are not significant and do not imply any increased certainty. Trailing zeros only count if the number has a decimal point. So 100 has one significant figure, but 1.00 times 10 to the second power, which is equal to 100, has three significant figures. So in the second example, we are more sure that 1.00 times 10 to the second power is exactly 100. 1.00 also has three significant figures. Finally, let's talk about exact numbers. Exact numbers are determined by counting or definition. For example, a pound is defined as 16 ounces. So 16, in that case, is an exact number. You could also count that you have two friends. So 2 would be an exact number. For the purposes of significant figures, exact numbers are infinitely precise and therefore have an infinite number of significant figures. For instance, 3 apples equals 3 with an infinite number of zeros and has an infinite number of significant figures because we are certain that it is exactly 3 and that every digit after 3 will be 0. 1 inch equals 2.54 centimeters with an infinite number of zeros after it and an infinite number of significant figures because it is a defined value. To summarize, significant figures are the values that we are certain about and the first uncertain value that we estimate. All non-zero integers, captive zeros, trailing zeros in numbers with decimal points, and an infinite number of digits in exact numbers are significant. Leading zeros and trailing zeros in numbers without decimal points are never significant. While it takes some time to learn all of the rules, I hope this video can be of some significance to you.
Nilay's chemistry video.